Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is G. Cole, and welcome to Homegrown, where I get to share with you some good music while talking to some great people. If you haven't yet subscribed, please do, so we can keep you updated when new material is available. We will be posting new episodes bi-weekly. Also, check out the website Homegrown with G. Cole to listen and for all things homegrown. We're also very, very interactive. Please follow me on Twitter, on Instagram, and on Facebook at MyGCole. Instead of the pain, I say freedom. For the colors it's discriminated upon, I cry freedom. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I cry freedom. Woman, haven't you taken as much as you can? Cry freedom.
This one's called Survival.
For the ordinary man.
For all the putting on resistance crowd, the ones that like that kind of tune, Bears made sure he dropped one for you on this one.
Give no time of day to, it is a miracle how we get through. Goes to bed early, try to dream up another.
Tracy Christie, big up himself.
Can't wait for the day he can truly say, today is my day, I pray freedom. For all the young minds that they let us.
Again, that one is called Survivor, ladies and gentlemen. It is Barris Hammond. It is from the brand new album, Never Ending, VP release, coming out on the 12th. Barris will be at VP Records in Miramar on the 13th. Make sure you go ahead and check it out. And let me see what's going on here. So we have guests in the building, like I promised you. You know, well, if I promise me, make it on, can't keep it. But today we did. Today we did. Today we did. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and do the official proper recording of the podcast. Give them the what they're amply do. All right. Hello, world. Hope you're feeling as good as I am. I want to go ahead and big up all my homegrown listeners out there. Welcome all the new listeners. If you haven't yet subscribed, please do, so we can keep you updated when new material is available. We do post new episodes bi-weekly. I want to thank everyone who've been listening, sharing. Please leave us a comment. We'd love to hear from you. Check out the website homegrownwithgcole.com to hear and for all things homegrown. To watch the videos, YouTube, subscribe to the YouTube channel, all right? Podcasts available on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, TuneIn, Spotify, iHeartRadio, all your podcast platforms. And again, subscribe to the YouTube channel. Today's episode brought to you courtesy of Cloth Talk, creating your own hieroglyphs, talking on fabric. You have something to say, say it on a t-shirt. I've been using them for the past 7 months and I love it. You can't beat the professionalism, definitely can't beat the creativity. Call them at 954-591-4064. 954-591-4064. Cloth Talk, clothing the world, one shirt at a time. Let me open up some microphones, see what I'm going, and then we'll figure out what's going on here.
Test. Good? One, two, check.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
That one's live. Let me hear yours.
Yeah, yeah.
Easy, yeah. Easy. See, sound like a voice, a dub. So, ladies and gentlemen, there's nothing I enjoy like sitting and talking to the legends and the upcoming legends. I'm going to give you that one because you're on your way.
Thank you, sir.
You know what I mean? I love it because I learn so much. You know, I enjoy sitting at the feet of the legends and soaking it all in. So many people know you from performing in Florida and all around the country, but today they're going to learn a little bit about the legend that is Pat Sashmo.
Yes, yes.
You know what I mean? So first of all, welcome to the show.
Yes.
Thanks for joining us.
Thank you.
Now, we're talking about a lot. I'm talking about history. I'm talking about you've worked with, and I had to put it on a flash drive. It's that much. All right. I'm talking about Derek Harriott, Lee Scratch Perry. You know what I mean? The Setas label. I'm talking about Trojan Records. I'm talking about Taxi.
Yes.
And we could keep going. All right, but we only have today,
right? Right,
so it's a lot going on. So what I'm gonna do right now, as a matter of fact, I denied you your applause clip. I gotta, you know, I normally don't do this, but give you a little applause. My team.
full house.
You just, ladies and gentlemen, you just can't see who's in here, all right? But that's how it is behind the scenes somewhere, all right?
Yeah.
That's the applause, people. But I'm gonna jump in one of your tunes right now.
All right.
We're going to catch him up. Get him up to speed.
Yeah, yeah.
Keep it moving, keep it grooving. It is homegrown.
Yeah, you're looking swell.
We're going through the classics, ladies and gentlemen. Go ahead and share the link. Thank you so much for joining us, all my Canadian people. EK, bless up yourself. We're taking you down memory lane right now. Tracy Christie, bless up, bless up, bless up. Thanks for the love. Hope, thank you so much for joining the party. We appreciate you. Yeah, man, that one's a big one. It's called Hello Dolly. That one, again, legendary Mr. Pat Sashmo. Now, that one is, that's a project with you and Eric Donaldson, right?
That one was with the Lee Scratch Perry.
Lee Scratch Perry?
Yeah.
He produced that one?
Yeah, yeah.
Was it on an album? Was it like an EP?
1969, that was. You know, he came to the house with a little cassette player. Because they used to do, all them guys used to come by my house to check out Family Man, you know. So,
oh, easy.
So when he came with this little player, you know, I told him, I say, hey, turn that on, you know. I was, what, 17? 17. So when he turned it on, I went, hello, darling. So he said, hey, let's go record this, man. Let's go record this. So he named me, he called me Pat Sachmo because, you know, my initials are PAT, Paul Anthony Thompson.
Okay.
Same with me.
Yeah. So we got Paul Senior, Paul Junior. Yeah.
Well, we said Paul One and Paul Two because the senior thing kind of sound like, you know. So we just said Paul One and Paul Two.
Paul One, Paul Two.
Yeah.
So that means that he gets to go in before since he's Paul One.
Right.
You know what amazes me? When I talk to somebody and they say, well, 1965, I can't remember what happened last week. I swear to you, I can't give you a date and stuff like that. I'm like, yo, this is, I like it.
I think it's technology, man.
Is that, that's true.
Maybe.
That's true.
Everything is so, well, if we don't know, then we can check back, you know, the date. When did I post that? Then you kind of know.
It is true. That's exactly what it is. Because I remember four phone numbers.
Right.
And their phone, four phone up phone as a kid. Trust me. Including my phone number right now. I know my wife, so I'm going to give her that. But that's pretty much where it stops. And, and then two other numbers, like my mom's office when I was a kid.
Yeah.
And some other chick from when I was a kid. That's pretty much it. But that's exactly what it is.
Exactly.
Now, Derek Harriott, many people know from being an artist.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of people. And when I say a lot of people, I mean, I guess my generation thereafter, we know him from the songs that he put out.
Right.
A lot
right.
of people aren't really aware of the legendary producer that he is. What was that experience like working with Derek Harriott?
Well, you know, it was all good. You know, Derek Harriott Chariot, you know, that was it. You know, he would have musicians that would perform at Sombrero, VIP, and it was Scotty, it was Chosen Few. Was a whole bunch of musicians, you know.
Right.
We all used to, you know, go around performing on a Derek Harriott Chariot, you know.
Right. Nice. Yeah. I'm gonna ask you this now because a lot of times I ask people all the time, is it pressure or whatever the case may be? But your pops is a legendary musician.
Mm.
You're a musician yourself.
Yeah.
Pressure.
I mean, we help each other out.
Act like here.
No, I mean, it's never been pressure because we help each other out. You know, we support each other. So, you know, like we always say we have different styles, you know, and that's true. I mean, he's more, you know, vocalist, singer. I'm more of a DJ, bass artist, you know, like.
Right, right.
So we kind of complement each other, I think.
So you, but you be singing sometimes.
Yeah.
Does that mean you be DJing sometimes too?
No.
No?
Yeah, he DJ too sometimes.
No.
Every now and then drop a thing?
Well, you know.
Ashaba?
He's good at you know, the DJ thing. I might do a little.
A little something?
Nothing like him, you know?
Like what he does?
Right.
I love it. I'll say this. I had an interview with Paul before.
Yeah.
On a podcast, right?
Yeah.
And he spoke about you with such reverence that I was like, man, that's definitely cool. Because what happens is, like I said, that's why you got to be careful of what you do and how you do it.
Right.
Because
right.
A lot of times you're leaving an impression and you don't know that you are.
True.
Good, bad, or indifferent.
True.
You know what I mean? So that's just a testament to the relationship you guys have going on. And it's really commendable. I dig it.
Yeah.
I dig it.
Thank you. Thank you.
Now, your musical talent discovered by who? Lee Scratch Perry?
Yeah.
How did that meeting go?
Well, you know, like I say, he came to the house with a little cassette player.
So that was the first time meeting him?
Well, he used to come back and forth regularly, you know.
Okay.
But because that's when Bob Marley was putting the band together, you know, and Family Man was regular at my house, you know, like.
Right.
I even asked him a few times, you know, hey, fam, show me a few chords, man.
Yeah.
And, you know, he showed me the bass, but, you know, he showed me a few chords, but I didn't really follow up, you know.
Right.
Sad to say, you know.
Right.
But all the musicians used to come to the house, and, you know, I met a lot of them, and, you know, it was an experience.
Good,
you know?
Memories.
Yeah.
Some good memories. You, I've always wanted to ask this to anybody who has been around Lee Scratch Perry from way back when. Was he always that eccentric character? Was he always like that?
Yeah, I would say.
Water. It's water, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. Water. But you know what? The most geniuses, true, pure geniuses, are a little different.
Yeah, you know?
That's true.
They are a little different, and rightfully so. Because I like it. You know, I don't see, it's eccentric, yes.
Such a bird. No, I'm just kidding.
True. Yo, he's dope though.
Nah, man. Yeah.
I would love to sit down and have I think it'd be a challenge, but I'd probably like to sit down and have a conversation with him and see what that's like, or maybe have the conversation and then translate for me. Ladies and gentlemen, we're talking about some beautiful music and some beautiful times. Can I drop one more for them?
Yeah.
Let's give them another one right now. Ladies and gentlemen, this one is called Can't Take It No More. Keep it moving, keep it grooving. Homegrown. Here we go.
Let's not fight anymore. I'll tie the bags and close the door. I'll never leave you. Oh no. Yet you lie right from the start. I can't convince my stupid heart not to believe you. Oh no. You got too good and strong, and there's not the slightest doubt.
It's a big tune, ladies and gentlemen. Go ahead and share the link.
Oh,
step aside. Still, I love you.
Ladies and gentlemen, that one is called Can't Take It Anymore. Pat Sashma, he said that one is a Bunny Lee.
Yes, yes.
Ooh, man, the legends, the legends, the legends. I don't know. I'm a kid in a candy store when it comes to musicians and the legends and stuff like that. Yeah. So I don't know how I would, you know, how productive I would be in the studio with a Bunny Lee, with a Lee Scratch Perry. You know what I mean? Yeah. Then when I said, sing, I mean, I have a question. I'd be like, yo, was that really you? But trust me, it's one of them things where you got to soak it in when the opportunity arises, because not very many people have that as their legacy. I worked with this person, I work with that person. Yeah. I'm sure they say the same thing when it comes about working with you.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? When they're telling their stories, you're in their stories as, man, I work with the great Pat Sashmo.
We hope, you know
what I mean? I'm pretty sure. I'm willing to bet on it. Now, you, of course, you can deliver that Louis Armstrong type vocals. Right?
Yes, yes.
Is that something that you've worked on, or is that just a natural thing for you?
Just come, you know, for some reason it just come natural, you know. Yeah. I mean from back then, and I still can do it now, you know, and don't really affect me, don't hurt me or nothing. So
wow.
You know.
Wow. Me try that, straight laryngitis. Straight laryngitis. No, it's obvious that he's a musical influence, but talk to me about, a lot of times, you know, a lot of people will probably put you as one of their musical influences, but talk to me about some of your musical influences.
Well, you know, Dennis Brown, Bob Marley,
mm-hmm.
Derek Harriott, you know, Nat King Cole.
Wow.
You know.
Yeah.
Louis Armstrong.
Right, right.
I have a lot of favorites. You know,
Nat King Cole, I think that's your favorite, right, bro?
Yeah.
One of your favorite.
Yeah, Nat King Cole, I would say.
You used to hear a lot of that around the house, huh?
Yeah, yeah.
Be like, you better say that, Pops. I heard that album all my life. I love it. I love it. I love it. Now, one thing I always ask about is covers.
Yeah. Yeah,
right? Because you know, covers, especially if the original was a smash.
Right, right. Know,
how do you decide, okay, I want to touch that one? Is it normally the producers that say, hey, Sashmi, you want to try it? Or you be like, I love that, I want to try it?
Producer, you know, many a times you're in the studio, you know, you're just hanging out and they play a rhythm and say, hey, Sash, do this, you know?
Yeah.
So that's how a lot of these songs, and it's one take, you know.
Wow. Wow. Ain't no punching me in.
Say, no. Hey, you know, I want to do that. No. It's good.
So the first cut is the deepest, right?
No retakes around here. Sing a reel. Get it right.
Yeah.
Get it right.
Yeah.
It's amazing. I heard rapper like Jay-Z bragging about one take. Yeah. One. You didn't have a choice back then, but you missed the one take, right?
Right.
Yeah. Yo. Oh, trust me. Like I said, as I watch these things, sometimes you do get some nice clips on YouTube and so forth.
It's very
fascinating to see what's going on and so forth.
Yeah.
Again, Derek Harriott, Lee Scratch Perry. Now, I'm sure many other people, you had opportunities to work with many other people who weren't as big named as these gentlemen were.
Well, band-wise, you know, I was, I guess, the first band I got involved with was what was this band?
In Jamaica? Or?
Yeah.
But Hell's Angels?
Before Hell's Angels was, I'll
Buccaneers
think...
Buccaneers?
Debonair, not Debonair. But it was Dennis Brown. Dennis Brown was...
Falcons?
The Falcons.
Oh, the Mighty Falcons.
The Mighty Falcons. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, you know.
I do my research.
Eh? I just went blank just now.
You know, I do the research.
The Mighty Falcons, Kesha Park Road, you know.
Yeah.
Dennis Brown, Bonnie Brown from Chosen Few, Cynthia Richards, you know, old bunch. Leroy Hasmout Wallace was playing drums.
Yeah. Rockers, baby, rockers. Yeah.
We used to do a lot of running from Kingston to the North Coast, you know, Ocheros, Negril, you know, used to do a lot of running, so especially to whenever Byron Lee left Jamaica, we used to go and just
fill the spot,
you know.
Yeah.
So
that was a vibrant circuit, though.
Yeah,
that whole, you know, people travel the world right now and they want to travel. I remember as a kid growing up, I spent a lot of time at the hotel because my mom worked at a hotel. And I'd see most of the people right now who we see, the Dean Frazers, the Sanchez, the Richie Spice. Yeah. I mean, the Richie Stevens.
Yeah.
All them names.
Yeah.
Third World. Yeah. I've seen them come through on the hotel circuit.
Right.
Which was almost like touring in the US right now.
Yeah. Yeah. True.
But I missed out on a little bit. I was a couple years late. I missed out. Now, you mentioned Dennis Brown. That's my favorite singer of all time. Genre. Yeah. Doesn't matter what the genre is, just D Brown.
Yeah, yeah.
A lot of time when you see your favorite artist and you see what they've become and grown into, you wonder, were they always like that? Was Dennis Brown always that great vocalist from a young...
Yeah, man. You know, I remember before we even worked together, I used to go Carib and see, what they call him, Little Boy Wonder or something like that.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
he was that guy.
Yeah, Carlos Malcolm and, you know.
Yeah.
I mean, back then was Carlos Malcolm Band. Like, it was like a battle between Carlos Malcolm and Byron Lee.
Right.
And, you know.
Wow.
And Dennis Brown was little boy wonder. You know, I think that's what they called him back then. But he had a great voice from back then, you know.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. And there's something pure about the music that you guys do.
Yeah.
You do have people who are purists when it comes to the music. You know what I mean? They like I always say, it's like the... three different foods on the plate that don't touch.
Yeah.
Don't make my chicken touch my veggies. Don't make it touch. You know what I'm saying? That's how the purists take it.
Right.
Yeah.
So right now when I listen to your work, it takes me to a place where nothing, and this is no indictment on the music of today.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Right.
Everything serves its purpose.
Yeah.
But the music that you guys put out takes me to somewhere where the music that's coming out right now can't.
See,
you know what I mean? Yeah, that's just how I feel about the music of then.
Yeah.
There's something about it where, and I guess the music that's coming out right now, it's likely that you might find somebody else sound like it, you know?
Right. Yeah.
But you're not gonna find another person sound like Pat Sashmore.
Mm-hmm.
There's not another person sound like Dennis Brown.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Was that a concerted effort on your part to stamp your individuality in what you're doing?
Well, you know, I would say. You're talking of the Sachmo voice or the natural.
Even when you're singing in a natural voice.
Yeah.
I'm not going to hear it and say, if I know your music and your catalog,
yeah.
I'm not going to hear it and say, who that? You don't hear Dennis Brown and say, I wonder if I, you know
right,
what I'm saying?
Right,
you
right,
don't.
Right.
But
right.
If you hear one of today's singer, you might have forgot Shazam the thing.
Right.
It don't mean the sound not good enough. It doesn't mean it's not good.
Yeah.
But you might have to pull up a Shazam real fast and say, you know what I'm saying? But I noticed that unique, that individuality, that stamped.
Right. Because when I'm doing a song, you know, like personal song, I don't try to sound, you know, it's different if I say, well, this is Satchmore, this is Nat King Cole or Tom Jones.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I find that I can touch these guys, you know, a little bit of them guys. And people say, man, you sound like, you know, but when I'm doing... my own thing, I try not to. It's different when it's say, you know, I do a Satchmo thing because Satchmo, you know, everybody know I'm
right.
You know, is a put on voice that you
right,
know?
right.
But you know,
well, it's hard to put on a voice and sing in Kino.
Yeah,
I've put on some voices before. You know what I mean? And according to J Vibe, I sang between the keys of U and R flat.
Yeah, what is it?
Between the keys of U and R flat. That's what J5 calls it. But because when it's not your natural voice, it's hard to. So that in itself is an enormous talent.
Yeah.
Now, there's another song that I was listening to and I saw you kind of vacillate between the two voices.
Yours
and the ear.
Yeah.
I'm really like that song.
Yeah.
I love that song.
I'm going to get him a piece of that one.
Yeah, Handful of Friends.
Handful of Friends.
Yeah.
Check it out, ladies and gentlemen. Keep it moving, keep it grooving. It is Homegrown. Ladies and gentlemen, this one's called Handful of Friends. Pat Sashmo.
But she wasn't a nice girl. done, kept my mind in the whirl. I said, all our dreams ever last, just to please my handful of friends. But they don't know that I still love her so, and I wonder if she would even care.
Ladies and gentlemen, share the link. We got a lot more music coming your way. Big, 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 big June, ladies and gentlemen. Ladies and gentlemen, again, a big tune. I love that song. I love that song. I ain't said that one is Derek Harrett again, right?
Yes, yes.
Mad. Ladies and gentlemen, we got a lot of people over here showing love. Tracy Christie, that's Canada's asking for an acapella. We'll get to that later, all right? We'll get to that for you later.
Acapella, yeah.
All right, because you hear the voice. The voice is still there. You know what I mean?
It looked like a lot of people didn't realize I had a natural. They thought I just did it, just Satchmo, you know?
Yeah. It's, man, that's what I said. When I hear the voice,
yeah.
If me try that, then I'll go print it tomorrow. Oh, Lord, EK, but that will guarantee a 24-year. A lot of people. Big up Leroy. Thank you so much for logging in. Tracy Christie, who else is there? Noel Hardy, a whole bunch of people from all over the globe right now are logging in. We appreciate you.
Yeah.
We appreciate you. Like we said, Derek Harriott, Lee Scratch Perry, I talk about all the producers because oftentimes we talk about the artists.
Yes.
And we don't get too much into the producers.
Right.
And like you mentioned, the musicians who sometimes go nameless.
Yeah, you know? Yeah. A lot of well-known musicians, you know, do a lot of studio work,
mm-hmm.
So on a lot of these records, it's, some of the regular, you heard of Aston Barrett, Carlton Barrett, so.
And those are the big legendary names you hear now. But then we're talking back then.
All background vocals. Peter Tosh.
Which one of the songs he's on?
Is it Make It With You, right?
No, it's a high school label there.
Not Make It With You? We Can Make It.
We can make it. Yeah, Make It. Yeah, Make It With You. Mm-hmm. I don't know if you have that one.
I think I do.
It's the picture hanging on the wall, really, man.
I think I have it.
Yeah.
I think we might be able to touch up one for you, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah.
If you're nice to us, we might touch something for you. Yeah. All right. Now, take us back to the early days as a musician when you decided that this was it. This is what I'm doing.
Well, I think the first time really was. There was a little thing they had at the radio station. They played this song, "This Is the Time That We Almost Live as One Brother." That's Desmond Dekanesis.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So they played that song. It was a festival song, you know. So So they say, hey, call in. Anybody want to call in and whoever do the best job with this song. So. My friend and I, Carleen, Brad Lyde, Lyde Levy with Carleen, and I sang that part. This is the time. And Lyde Levy went, you and I to you. So they say, hey, you guys won. So we went up and got a prize up at the radio station. Was it JBC?
JBC Radio 1.
Yeah. got a double album, Otis Redding. That's another guy I love too, Otis Redding.
excellent
the history
artist.
Yeah. And then, you know, that's when I really started, you know, getting into the music thing. And a whole bunch of us, Bonnie Brown and us, we used to jump on a bus and go up Red Gal Ring, you know, like check out Meritone.
Yeah.
You know, but we just used to take over the back of the bus, you know, just sit down in the back of the bus and people start clapping and stamping feet. And I started, hello, Dolly, say hello. And, you know, people would get up and look around and, you know.
Yeah.
So that's how I really, you know, I started thinking seriously about getting into the music thing, you know.
Right.
So between 69 I started, and in 72, I left for Brooklyn.
Mm-hmm.
Left Jamaica, went to Brooklyn and started traveling around singing, you know, between back and forth from Brooklyn to Toronto, you know, the Wild Bunch,
right.
What's the name of this band, the Wild Bunch. Bonnie Ruggs was the lead singer, and then he left and joined Third World.
And you replaced him.
And I replaced, you know, so we used to travel a lot back and forth from Brooklyn to Toronto, and used to go and back up. We used to back up a lot of the well-known artists, every artist you can think of.
Right.
And then in 1975, we were there, and Bob Marley was there and said, hey, you know, we're looking for a band to open. So we opened for Bob Marley, the Wild Bunch. Yeah.
Nice.
Wild up the place. It was nice. Yeah, man.
I love it. Now, is that the band you were sharing vocal duties with D Brown, or was that the previous one?
Well, it was with D Brown, was that one.
The Falcons?
Falcons.
Oh, okay.
But you backed up Dennis Brown with the Wild Bunch, or no?
Well, Dennis Brown, we back up just about every artist you can think of. Up in, you know, Ken Boot, you know, Ori Sandy, Alton Ellis, every artist you can think of, we backed up,
right?
You know, back in Toronto. So
now, what's it like for you growing up seeing the musical? Because sometimes we see it from afar. It's right in your household,
right?
You know what I mean. So you're pretty much on stage doing this from as far back as you can remember,
right?
So this is inevitable.
Well, I'm in 89, you know. I was born 89, so this was before I was born.
Right.
But I mean, it's inspiring, you know what I mean?
Right.
Like that's, he's among the best of the best.
Right.
You know what I mean? I'm working my way to be among the best.
You're on your way.
I'm on my way.
You're on your way.
I'm like less than halfway there, you know. But
you're good, man.
We're getting there, you know.
2020. But it's amazing. A lot.
I'm not
of
running for president, but no.
I'll be security. Hey, somebody did it before it worked out. A lot of times people say they're doing it, they end up on the White House, and it's got to roll with it.
Hey.
So if it weren't for us, we're rolling with it. All right, tax cuts, we get to fly that plane.
Yeah.
But it is what it is.
Yeah, man.
It is what it is. I really dig it because a lot of times, you know, it's great to have that frame of reference. It's great to have somebody who you can bounce. Because you know how we stay right now.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody's giving advice.
Yes.
The people who are most quick to give advice are normally the least qualified to give it.
Yeah.
That's the truth. You know what I'm saying? But it's good to have somebody there who you can have a frame of reference, who can give you some constructive advice.
Well, definitely, you know, with my band, like, there's a lot of advice that he gives me that, you know.
Fire
that,
on it.
That, no.
Fire him.
No. That, you know, he gives me a lot of great advice about how to, you know, work as a band and be successful and you know,
manage them egos and manage the different personalities and all that. Listen, it's not a bad thing. We spoke about it. You got to have an ego to do this. The issue is when the ego is bigger than you.
You know
what I mean? Because that's what keeps you going. But it's just about balancing all those stuff. And then you got four or five different personalities.
Mm-hmm.
So again, knowledge comes.
Yeah, I work with him too.
He works with the reggae soldiers as well.
Nice. I need to come out and see one of those shows, man.
Of course.
I'm strapped down in this here like a caveman, like locked up in here in front of microphones every day. I gotta get out there and see the real show, because I ever since this, I very seldom get to be out there on the road.
Yeah.
But, you know,
when the time is right, man.
Time is right, I'll be out there.
But when I started, you know, they had me down as a soul singer back in Jamaica, you know. You know, because, you know, the reggae, back then reggae was kind of, you had to be from the streets, like you know,
yeah.
I mean, reggae couldn't be too proper and too, you know, polished, refined, you know.
Yeah.
But then, you know, things changed a little. I mean, Marley
edged it up.
You know.
You're absolutely right, though, when you think about it.
It's
you know, reggae was that, which is why, and you can tell why, because Jamaica, we love some soul, some R&B.
Right.
We love them thing there.
Right.
Temptations, them kind of, those kind of music.
Yeah, man.
So I could see why they'd have you down as a soul, the balladeer.
Well, certain pronunciation, you know, you couldn't be too proper when you sing it, you know, but then you started hearing about, you see a lot of American artists or artists from all over the world doing reggae.
Right.
Johnny Nash. I remember seeing Johnny Nash and Bob walking downtown.
Wow.
You know, just strutting downtown together.
Wow.
Johnny Nash did a lot of Marley songs too, you know.
Yep. So, I think there's an LP out there somewhere. Covers. Yeah.
Guava Jelly and, you know.
Yeah.
Stir It Up, all them things. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. I dig it. Now, what's the main... You did the Jamaica scene, right? Which is, like I said, down the coast and all that stuff.
Yeah.
Beautiful times when you could actually, for lack of a better word, tour Jamaica.
Mm. Yeah.
They're trying to revive that, and I really like it.
Yeah.
But that's when you're touring Jamaica, and then you come up here. Now, outside of the economics,
right,
what's the difference with the music scene there versus the music scene here when you guys are doing the band thing?
Well, I don't know. Like, it's a... To me, it's more like a cutthroat kind of thing here, you know. I mean,
dog eat dog.
Right.
Very competitive.
Yeah.
Sometimes unnecessarily so.
Right.
Wow.
You know.
Wow.
But it's still, you know. I mean, most of the time here, I was more in a country club settings and thing, you know.
Right.
Like Florida, you mean?
In Florida.
Florida.
But you know, right now I'm kind of getting back to the roots of reggae.
Right. So you ready to hit the road again?
Well, you know, recording wise,
I'm ready.
You know,
ready. <man.
laughs> I'm gonna see you on TMZ. You and Paul, they're tearing places up. Y'all look alike, so you be like, I didn't do it. It was him. It was him. Now I had Jamira Morgan in here the other day, right? And I was talking because he's getting ready to go out on the road with his dad.
Mm-hmm.
And to me, when you grow up, you know, you're a kid doing your thing, see Pops doing his thing. But how amazing is it to be able to now, as an adult, go out there and share the stage with your Pops?
It's cool. It's definitely cool. I mean, the first time we worked together was a song called Brown Eyes.
Mm-hmm.
It's a song that I wrote a while back, and we've been redoing over the years. We're actually going to redo it with a band, like, just once and for all, get a nice live lick, you know, re-lick of the rhythm. And
I love that song, by the way.
Thank you.
I'm a little ticked it's not on Apple Music, but it's all good.
Yeah, exactly. I'm trying to keep it. I'm trying to let people kind of forget about it a little and then come back with the
like it's brand new.
Yeah. Because I think it's a good song. And we, you know, we share vocals on it. And it's one of my favorite songs, you know, like, and it's cool. Like, it's really cool. Like, performing it. And even when we gig together with Reggae Soldiers, it's nice, you know, like. And especially because, like, of our different styles, it's like we can cover so much
ground,
material.
Yeah.
Like, so many years of material, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It's like a bridge, you know what I mean?
So,
like,
so when you're out there, you're doing a whole show. It's not just, let's feature these one or two songs.
Right, yeah.
Nice. Yeah. I get what you mean. So you can take it way back to the classics if you wanted to and come all the way back.
Yeah.
Yo, I love that. I got to come out to the show. Now, reggae music is the voice of the people, they say, right?
Yeah.
It's coming from a time when news stations didn't necessarily bring you the news that you wanted to hear. They're giving you the news that they want you to hear.
Right.
So it was the reggae music that brought it to people. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And reggae has that thing where it's not just the lyrics, but the song itself that almost can tell you what the climate is. You know, certain songs you can tell the tension, the political climate, where things are cool and whatever the case may be. At that time when you were recording with the Derek Harrits and Lee Scratch Perry, what was the climate like, not just musically but politically and so forth, in Jamaica at that time?
Well, politically, you know, I didn't really follow that up.
Right, much, the politics,
you know?
thing.
You know.
Right.
But I know I perform at the Jamaica House for Michael Manley.
Wow.
You know, I perform there. I didn't really follow the politics thing that much.
Just doing some music.
Yeah.
Doing the music.
Right.
And sometimes that's how you gotta be, because even in this day and age, even if you're just doing music,
mm-hmm.
you know, people call you. It happens here in the U.S. I'm like, oh, come perform at this event.
Yeah.
And you gotta be so conscious of it because of the fact that, okay, is that political party assigned to it or affiliated with it or whatever the case may be. But it you know, as history reveals everything, a lot of times nobody's affiliated. We're just doing some music.
Well, that's the thing. And then we think, like, you know, if I can think back, it's like I might have done private party for people that were involved with things that I wouldn't agree with, but I would never know, you know? And it's like, I mean, if you know about it and it doesn't, you know, match up with how you are,
mm-hmm.
then yeah, you know, I would say,
right,
you know, be careful. But sometimes you don't even
know
who you're working for, you know?
And it happens on the biggest and brightest of stages, mm-hmm. too.
Yeah.
Right now, you go on the biggest, you go on the Grammy stage, you don't know who you're working for.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But it's just, a lot of times there's a message, especially when it comes to reggae music, that as I sit back, and correct me if I'm wrong, it's kind of like when you sit back and you listen, the different eras, you can tell the tone
mm-hmm.
yeah.
of what times are like and
yeah,
so forth
yeah.
at
yeah.
that time. And that's one of the things with reggae music that I really, 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 really dig. Now, we spoke a little bit earlier about this song called We Can Make It. I'm going to drop a little piece of that for the masses. Ladies and gentlemen, this one is Pat Sashmo. We Can Make It. Keep it moving, keep it grooving. It is Homegrown. Go ahead and share the link, ladies and gentlemen. We're coming back real quick. Yes, ladies and gentlemen. I want to big up everybody right now. Leroy, big up yourself. Thank you so much. We got a bunch of people in the chat room right now having a good time with us. Tracy Christie, absolutely
yo,
right.
Yo.
Politics, right? Your mic's on. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
All right, we good. Again, bless up everybody. Noel, let me see here.
I was just saying hi to the people then too, you know.
Bless up the people. Yeah, yeah. Bless up the people. Ladies and gentlemen, we got Pat Sashmo in the building. We got Paul Anthony in the building. You know what I mean? Two great, 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 great musicians. Legend of his day. Future legend. All right.
Thank
I'm
you.
I'm putting it out there.
This legend in the making.
To be, right?
Huh?
Yeah. You got to put it in the ether. You got to put it out.
Right, right, right.
You know Respect. What I mean? And I like I told you before, man, I appreciate the grind and everything because right here in South Florida, and, yeah. and I feel something's coming.
Yeah.
We're getting to the corner.
But I think I think you bringing it up, I would say you bringing it up about the South Florida and you
right.
making a point to, you know, promote South Florida. I like that. You know what I mean?
I
like
appreciate it, man.
That's an integral part of it, I think.
But we got the talent. We got the talent. So let's get it out there. And mm-hmm. like I said, people are paying. We're going to take, as a matter of fact, we're going to take away the prefix. You know? We're going to take away the South Florida thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because a lot of times that's the hurdle too.
Yes, mm. yes.
You know, it's just artists that happen to reside here.
In South Florida. You know what I mean? Exactly.
I just happen to be more fortunate than you, Tracy Christie, up there in Canada, because I can go see the artist when I feel like it. That's all it is. You know, it's not about South Florida or not. But we thank you all for always supporting the artists, because a lot of people, especially, you know, when reggae music, a lot of our support system is not local. Our support comes from elsewhere.
True. Right. True.
So we're really, really appreciative of all of that stuff.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
The movie The Harder They Come. One of the most renowned Jamaican films, and you had a cameo. So I was watching the little clip there. How did that, talk to me about that.
We always hang out, you know, musicians hang out at the studio and thing. And we were hanging out that day and in the yard, you know.
Mm-hmm.
That's Byron Lee studio there.
Oh, that was Byron Lee studio?
Yeah.
Well, okay.
but, you know, we were hanging out and saw this, you know, somebody pointed to this guy, you know, he said, hey, hey, that's Jimmy Cliff, you know. I say, yeah. But he had on his little gunmouth pants and pointed to shoes and
the hat.
You know, the hat. So, yeah, they're making a movie, man. Making a movie. So, oh. Then they wanted some extras in the studio.
Right, right.
So that's how I ended up in there.
And right place, right time.
Yeah. And, you know, what's his name was doing the door, holding the door. That's... Wemnium, Man, I'm blank right now.
I can't remember Toots, if you're from yesterday.
Toots, but it's a scene was Toots, right? Toots and the Maytals?
Yeah, but the door...
Horse mouth wall?
Was all in the door there. His son did have the big hit, Taurus Riley.
Oh, Jimmy Riley.
Jimmy Riley was all in.
Oh, really?
Jimmy Riley.
No, I got to go back and look.
Yeah. You have to look, man, because Jimmy Riley was... He was a doorman, you know.
Yeah.
And say, who that? You know, and then, you know, going on. So, you know, so that's... Wow. That's how that it come about, you know.
Like, wow. Yeah. And you're just so cool with it. Yo, listen, it's a generation thing. Like, I'm going to tell you something. Let's see if that was me.
Yeah.
Oh, snap. I'll be rolling through school with the YouTube clips, right?
Well, I'll show people.
Tell them it was you.
I'll show people.
I'll be rolling through. Yo, this is me.
Well, yeah. No, I mean, my dad.
I'ma tell him it was me. I look a little different. Don't worry about it. Cinematography. No, that movie.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sure you saw the film. I went back and watched it the other day.
Yeah.
Because I was in Cleveland and they have this little artsy area downtown.
Mm.
I went and bought some vinyl. I bought Stevie Wonder's Hotter Than July. I bought In Mint Condition, The Harder They Come.
Yeah?
Yeah, wow. But it's one of the things, when you listen to it now, you gotta, let me go back and watch the movie, because I've seen it years and years ago.
Yeah.
And I feel like the movie pretty much detailed the reggae music industry at the time.
Yeah, true.
You know, and at least through the eyes of Trevor Rohn, and you know what I mean, and Henzo Perry, they're the writers, directors of the film.
Yeah.
You can say that was an accurate depiction, right?
True.
Of how it
it
was.
Yeah.
Wow.
Exactly. Yeah.
Wow. You know. It hasn't changed much. Technology and the swing is a little different.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but for me, back then, I think it was a situation where you took your talents to the big man, is what we could call it.
Yeah.
You take your talents to the big man, and all you brought was your talents. You know? So as a result, they'd put you on the track. And a lot of the revenue from that you wouldn't see, because all you brought was your talent.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
They brought studio time, they brought musicians, they brought everything else.
Yeah.
In this day and age, you show up with the whole damn song.
Yeah.
And they're still trying to take it off.
True.
You know what I'm saying? So it hasn't changed much.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? But yeah, that's gotta be a highlight. To just, you know, like I said, right time, right place.
Yeah, that's a true story, man. True thing, you know.
Wow.
You see, once you go and say, hey, you know, how it go? Them just shelf the music. You don't see them just put it on the shelf.
Literally.
Yeah.
Don't ask any questions. Before I have on. Yeah. We don't encourage any of you to go rogue like he did.
No.
But the truth is, it hasn't changed much.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you speak up and stuff like that. I have an episode coming out with an entertainment attorney. Right? I spoke to an entertainment attorney. We talked the business, because we have a lot of upcoming artists and producers that watch the program.
Yeah.
And the goal is, like, you know, get the information out there.
Right.
Yeah.
You know, we loosely say a lot of times that the information is at your fingertips.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Which it is.
Yeah.
But if it's in French, it don't matter if it's at your fingertips. Because you can't really, honestly, the language is what's complicated.
Mm-hmm.
You know, now, making music in 2018, because you're about to hit the studio, you got stuff coming up on whatever the case may be.
Yeah.
What's the difference with the energy making music now? That making music then?
Well, you know, you're a little more experienced. I think, you know, you know what to look out for and what not to, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm just getting back in the studio thing and, you know, have to go about it differently from, you know.
Right.
Just have your own, you just have to try to connect with people that you trust,
mm-hmm.
you know.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta be trusting, you know. You can't go with just a handshake and say, well, hey, you know.
It don't work that way.
Yeah. Because Marley and them, man, it's the same way they go with the handshake thing, you know. But they make it big time that.
Right.
But even in the end, because of a handshake thing, it's they're trying to.
Yeah.
Take
it all back.
Yeah.
The handshake thing don't work.
No.
Mm-hmm.
No.
And a lot of the things that happen, we don't see. We hear about.
Right,
But we didn't see it. So, I guess the long and short of it is, get your stuff in order.
Yeah, you know.
If you're not doing it right, don't do it.
Right, mm-hmm. right.
You
right.
know, because you're going to be mad at something later, when the truth is that you need to be mad at.
Right.
I like it.
I think right now, I guess I would say a difference is, like, you know, everybody is seeking to do everything themselves, you know, like, I mean, the resources are there for us to function as a label, pretty much.
Independently each, doing your
yeah.
thing.
Right.
Yeah. So, I mean, yeah. I mean, that might be a one difference, you know. Right. But
you know, I forgot to check the big man like Ivan.
Yeah, I mean, well.
Wow. But that's, and you have a pretty good grasp mm-hmm. on the engineering side of the fence.
Mm-hmm.
So that must make everything work a lot smoother
yeah,
too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, man.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But how do you tell, how do you tell legendary Pat Sashmo, he ain't singing it right?
Because.
Yo, but.
I mean, I don't have to do that. I'm not that I've encountered that situation. But
you can tell though when you're off, you know, when yeah, you're
right.
on and when you're
yeah,
off.
He would yeah. know. He would know he before. Can. Yeah, he would know before I would
I've
say.
I've been in the studio. Some people don't know. I'll know. The album released. Album dropped 3 years ago. They still don't realize it.
Yeah, boy, no, say. Boy, you know that it kind of sound off.
Yeah, but you listen some old time music and you hear mistakes in them, you know.
Oh yeah,
you know.
Oh yeah, especially your own music.
Well, oh, yeah. old music.
Yeah, yeah.
You remember one about Hey Danny? I don't know if you know one. It's a Calypso song. I don't remember who sing it, but Hey Danny, a man inside. But so he said, you know, this guy was singing about. So what he supposed to, so what I really had to do in it's a so rat I really he says somebody so rat and they just release it anyway. A lot of songs released with
errors on it. Yeah,
you can't bother redo it.
Guilty. It's like, you
know. It's a one take. Everything is one take.
Yeah.
Everything.
Well, the music yeah. sound pretty good.
Sound pretty
it's like
good,
one yeah. one thing, it's not worth it.
And you listen back at home, you're like, I got one of them. It's not like Elephant Man with a lisp. But I'm not doing this over.
It's a talking parrot, yeah, talking parrot, man. That's something like that, yeah. Some old
no, you're gonna make me look for the song. Yeah. I'm gonna go dig it up now.
Yeah.
But that's what makes music so good mm-hmm. is that even the imperfections are beautiful,
right?
You know what I mean?
Right.
Because the feel and everything is right.
Right. True.
You know, you're searching for perfection. You listen to Mariah, you listen to Whitney, you're like, man, they nailed it. They're probably at home, be like, damn, I didn't hit that one.
Yeah,
you know
yeah,
I mean?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Right, exactly.
It's music. I love it. Ladies and gentlemen, we got more music coming your way. Again, go ahead and share the link. I'm going to drop this one for you right now. It's called What a Wonderful World. Keep it moving, keep it grooving. It is homegrown. I'm gonna take this one from the top, ladies and gentlemen. It's a wonderful, wonderful world. Pat Sashmo. Big up all the production people. Maurice Walker.
Blessed
Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. The aliens got us. Facebook did what they did. So let me get this new link. See, I'm already getting, and I gotta be so grateful for everyone. They'll just hop on to the next link.
Oh, you that?
Yeah, man. Yes, 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 yes. Gene, thank you so much for joining us. I'm going to go ahead and copy this one, free it up so that you can all share it again. But we're having a wonderful time this evening. Like I said, we've got some wonderful guests in the building. And, you know, like I said to you before, Paul, when I'm sitting here by myself, I don't get this kind of love. But I'm not hating. You know? I don't open my mic. You know, when I'm sitting by myself, I get thumbs up. I don't get hearts. Nah.
I think they don't want to interrupt you. You know, that's what it is. You're feeling it. We're feeling it, but we just don't want to, you know, brought the vibes or anything, you know.
That's what it is, right? That's some serious damage control right there. I appreciate it all. Oh, man. Ladies and gentlemen, we are here. Again, go ahead. I'm going to give you an opportunity to share the link. Thank you so much for everybody coming back. And you know what? I'm going to give you a little piece more of that tune because I really, 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 really dig it. This one is What a Wonderful World, all right? Pat Sashmore, the legend. Keep it moving. Keep it grooving. It is homegrown.
I see trees of green, red roses too. I see them blue. What a wonderful world.
Courtney, thank you so much for joining. Mr. Marla, Raymond Johnson, everybody logging on. I appreciate you.
Eyes of blue and clouds of white. The bright blessed day, the dark sacred night. I think to myself, what a wonderful world.
All right, I'm going to cut it right now so that Zuckerberg don't Zucker punch us one more time. All right. Thank again so much, ladies and gentlemen. You know what? Let me get the link to this new one and I'll put it in the old chat. Well, everybody's back. So
Zucker punch. Did you make
Zucker punch? You know what I mean? Hey, man, that one is copyrighted. You can't take that. Zuckerberg done got us. Ladies and gentlemen, we're having a wonderful time. We're talking to the legendary Mr. Pat Sashmore. We're talking to future legend himself, Mr. Paul Anthony, doing what he does. Make sure you go out there and support the music. When these gentlemen come to your town, go out and support and support and support the music. All right. Oh, my bad.
There we go. There
you
we
good?
Go. In the know.
Easy. We're talking about I talk a lot about the business of music.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because it is the part of it that is most lacking. You'll see, for example, right now, some of the most talented musicians are coming out right now.
Yeah.
Talented singers.
Yeah.
And when you check it, they're all coming from Edna Manley School of Arts and stuff like
that.
Yeah. But you don't see the managers coming. You don't see a whole bunch of managers and entertainment attorneys and so forth coming out.
True.
So every time I talk to somebody who has experience and tenure in the game, I always say, what words, what jewels can you drop on the youngsters coming up right now for the betterment of this music business?
What words? Well,
just leave them, give them some jewels.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, you know, it's just have to love what you're doing, enjoy what you're doing, and, you know, just go in it. Don't go in there just to step all over people. Go in there and look for people who can help you along the way, you know, put you on the right tracks, you know.
Wow.
So, you know.
You know what's wowing to me about what you just said? It's simple words.
Yeah.
But the truth is, it's gospel.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? The second thing that is so wowing, and you can go and research this, is I asked Paul a similar question. Yeah. We did that first interview.
Yeah.
And it's damn near word for word. What the answer was.
Yeah.
So.
Well. I guess it worked.
I didn't tell him to say that. And he didn't tell me
to say that. Yeah. That means you're doing something right. You're doing something right. All right. But here's the problem with that. Now, if him go out the road tomorrow, cuss off somebody, they will blame you. Oh, man. Oh, man. You know, I talk about the barrage of greatness, man. The barrage of greatness that comes out of the small island.
Yeah, yeah.
Musically speaking, the influence that we get from you, sometimes you'll sit back and you listen to today's music.
Yeah.
And all it is your music on a different instrumental.
True.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I personally, on behalf of the masses out there, the fans of music, want to say thanks so much for giving us that.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, true. A lot of people don't have the legacy to look for. You know, it's almost like coming up and you're the first person to go to college. There's nobody in your family could tell you what college is like.
Yeah, true. Yeah.
You know, so we appreciate all the stuff that you've done. And we always talk about validation from reggae music. I'm going to ask you about this. Because I know you are doing music here in the U.S.
Yeah.
All right? When it comes to reggae music, maybe it's a South Florida thing, who knows? It seems that the validation from it comes from Jamaica. So it's almost like, because you got a lot of artists right now here who live here.
Yeah.
But they stamp it from Jamaica.
Yeah.
To get the validation for it.
Yeah.
Even though, from an economic standpoint, it's, you know, the Cali bands, the people who are from here.
Right.
They're the ones raking in the revenue.
Right.
But there's something, it's almost like street cred.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Did you have that same kind of situation going on when you were making music with these generals right here back then? Yeah.
Well, yeah, I would say, you know, I would say yes.
Yeah.
You know?
Still needed that stamp of approval from home.
Well, it's just, you know, sometimes I even feel like, you know, I'd like to possibly go back and,
mm-hmm.
you know,
yeah,
do some,
make some moves some over there.
Yeah,
some home recordings.
Back home recording, yeah, yeah.
That'll probably be a great feel to be doing
some
that.
Some originals and thing, you know. I'm,
yeah.
I'll be coming out with some originals soon, you know. So.
Well, we're going to drop a new song from him in a minute. Yeah. A minute, that's one of your more recent recordings.
Yeah.
Project. Got something on the way? Something in the works coming up?
Talking about an album, like
album, EP.
Yeah,
yeah.
You know,
is it too early to tell the masses about it? You want to let them wait some more, or we can talk to them a little bit about it?
Can't wait. Well, you know, not too early.
Too early. Yeah. Premature.
Yeah.
That's a business, you know. Premature.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? A man take a picture and it look like album cover and start telling about the album. Haven't recorded the first song yet.
Yeah. Right?
Yeah.
Now, talk to me about Florida Symphonic Pops.
Oh, yeah, that's when I first came to Florida in 1988.
Mm-hmm.
I did some performances with the Pops,
mm-hmm.
you know, but that's more like, you know, ballads.
Oh, okay, like, okay.
Like, you know, I mean, this was like an orchestra.
I think
it was about 88, or I forget how many people, almost 100 people in that orchestra.
Wow.
So, you know, I mean, it's like, you know, I mean, getting up there and doing songs with them. You know, I perform at FAU with them, Meet Me Downtown Boca, you know, but it was like doing You'll Never Walk Alone. I don't know if you know that song.
Right.
That's a big, powerful song. You
wow.
know? Yeah, so.
Wow. I think maybe you should let people hear. Maybe.
Yeah, because you know what? We had Tracy, and she's still hanging on for her thing right now. Yeah. She's like, yo, I'm a chewing. Courtney, big up yourself. Thank you so much for joining us. Hubert, thank you so much. Hope is here. EK is here. Mindy's here. Briggy, oh, big up yourself, Briggy, is here. And yeah, they're asking for that a cappella thing.
Yeah,
man, they're asking for that a cappella. They can be a little demanding.
A cappella.
Yeah. I mean, I could give you a dance already if you want.
No,
I'm just if you want to give them a piece.
Little piece, like what? Old songs,
Never Walk Alone.
Never Walk Alone. How about
that? Can get them a little. My love has faded away. Yay, yay. How wrong I was yesterday. I let love slip right through my hands just to please my handful of friends.
Remember that one day? Big tune. Ladies and gentlemen, you hear the vocals still there. We didn't do no me, none of that. You know what I mean?
You want to get them, You'll Never Walk Alone? It's too powerful.
When you walk through a storm, Hold your head up high and don't be afraid of the dark. At the end of a storm is a golden sky and the sweet silver song of a lark. Walk on through the wind, walk on through the rain, though your dreams be tossed and blown. That's it, that's it, that's it.
I don't want to follow that one, boy. I don't want to be the next act.
That ain't even a climax of the song. You know? Tell you.
Man. Yeah. And I can see why you could sing with the orchestra type.
Well, is that.
You know, call about the pops them, you know?
Yeah. Yeah. Travel through the, you know what I mean? Touring as pops and pops.
Pops and the pops.
When I sing them songs, people say, man, you need to be on Broadway doing these things. You know,
it is a Broadway sound.
Yeah. Like, you know.
That's a big, big.
Yeah.
Let's do some amphitheaters big around song, here. Yeah. Hollywood, call me. All right. I'm not the manager, but I do security details. All right. We got it covered. Now, latest recording, Wake Up Everybody.
Yeah.
Talk about that tune.
It's a song I always love, you know, mm-hmm. but with what's going on in the world today, you know, mm-hmm. I just had to.
Yeah.
I just had to do that one.
Drop an ounce of positivity on
him. Yeah. You know, I just had to do that one with, you know, just the way I feel about what's happening in the world.
Right.
You know.
The good thing about this gift of music and his talent is that you do have a way to influence. You know, drop something positive out there.
Right.
Will it hit everybody? Not necessarily.
Right.
But it will hit somebody.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And that's all we ask.
That's it, man.
Definitely.
That's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to drop the song for you right now. This is the brand new tune. It's called Wake Up Everybody. All right. Keep it moving. Keep it grooving. It is Homegrown.
Wake up, everybody. No more sleeping in bed, no more backward thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much.
Wake up everybody, ladies and gentlemen, go ahead and share the link.
There's so much hatred, war and poverty. Wake up all the teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up. The world is in their hands. When you teach the children, teach them the very best you can.
I love it, ladies and gentlemen. I'm sure you do too.
The world won't get no better if we just let
no sir. We have to take it from the top, ladies and gentlemen. When we get a big one, we gotta pull it up. All right, we gotta pull it up. Make sure you go ahead and look for this song. Is it out yet?
No, October 15th.
Got pre-order right now. October 15th, it'll be out officially. Wow. Pre-order right now.
You heard that, ladies and gentlemen. Go ahead and get this one when it comes out. All right.
Wake up, everybody. No more sleeping in bed. No more backward thinking, time for thinking ahead. The world has changed so very much from what it used to be. There's so much hatred, war and poverty. Wake up all the teachers, time to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say.
Welcome, Gia. Thank you so much for joining us.
All right. The world is in their hands.
The title is Wake Up Everybody, EK.
The children, teach them the very best you
can. It's not out yet.
October 15th.
The world won't get no better if we just let it be. No, no, no.
Leroy is a big tune boss.
you know, my
respect.
We gotta change it, yeah. You and me. Wake up all the doctors, make the old people well. They're the ones who suffer and catch all the hell. They don't have so very long before their judgment day. Won't you make them happy before they pass away? Wake up all the builders.
Yes, 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 it is a big one.
A new land. I know we can do it if we all lend a hand. The only thing we have to do is put it in our mind. Surely things will work out. They do it every time. The world won't get no better.
Dave, big up yourself. Thank you so much for joining.
Let it be. No, 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 no. The world won't get no better. We gotta change it, yeah. You and me. Change it now. Change it, yeah. Can't do it alone.
That's a big tune. That's a big tune.
You know?
I like that song. It feels right.
Yeah, you know?
It feels right. Feels right. It's a beautiful song, of course, in a classic.
Yeah.
You know,
yeah.
Lyrics the whole nine, but it feels right.
Right, exactly. Yeah.
You know? Yeah. So consider it a hit. You just want to sit out the park. Home run.
Thank you.
I love it. I was talking to you off mic, the collaborative effort in terms of you're doing the engineering, you're doing the mixing, you're doing the vocals.
Maurice mixed the rhythm and produced the music. Nice. I did the vocals, and then we had it mastered down in Miami.
Nice.
So, yeah.
Nice. Yeah. And you say this is coming out on October 13th.
October 15th.
15th.
Yeah, yeah. And then you can pre-order right now on iTunes, but it will be released on the 15th.
I love it. Ladies and gentlemen, you know what we need to do? Let's go ahead and get Pat back up on the Billboard charts, right?
Yeah.
So everybody go there and get this one. Let's start taking over Billboard.
Yes, yeah, man. Yes.
You know, South Florida, we need somebody. We're taking away the prefix.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, right.
But
right.
It's a home team. At least we know.
Still.
You know, we know. We're quietly in the cut.
True.
You know?
Exactly, man.
I love it. Shows and so forth. Let the masses know where they can find you. Let's start with you.
Me. Mm-hmm. Well, this Sunday, we're going to be at Zimroy's birthday bash at Moments. You know what I mean? It's going to be a big vibe. You know, everybody probably going to be in the house.
Yep, you know what I mean?
I'll be touching the stage with, you know, with some special guests.
Doing what you do.
Yeah, man. We got Boynton Pirate Fest at the end of the month. That's the 27th of October. Taste of Lauderdale Lakes. November 17th, Reggae Soldiers. My dad, he's doing a lot of private events, private parties. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? He performs at the Reggae Soldiers. We go every Sunday to the Boca Resort.
Nice.
But we want to work on something good for him, you know?
Right.
Yeah, like...
So he's about to be on the road.
Yeah, that's why we're trying to get the music. We want to get the music first, then we, you know, talk about the touring and them thing there. So.
I love it. And when the project is ready, you come back and see us so we can.
you
know what I mean?
Yes.
But here's what we do, though. When the project is ready,
yeah,
come through before it's out. Because we can play the whole song before it's out.
Yeah. True.
You know what I mean? We play the whole song, no interruptions, no nothing.
Before it's out.
Right. So come see me a week before.
Yes.
And we going to tell a message, you need to go get this one. I will Vladimir your computer and I'll know if you got it or not. I will know if you got it or not. All right?
Yeah, man.
Drop some social media information where you can reach.
So you can check him out on Instagram, Pat Satchmo, Facebook.com/Pat Satchmo. Or you could check me out, Paul Anthony Reggae, on Instagram. Just Google Paul Anthony Reggae. Yeah.
They'll find it.
Yeah.
They'll find it.
If you Google Paul Anthony, you're going to get a couple things.
Right.
You know, we don't know where that's going to lead, but just say Paul Anthony Reggae.
Right.
I mean, it's a common name, I guess.
Nah, make sure you go out there and get the music, ladies and gentlemen. Paul Anthony's got some brand new stuff out too. The video is doing crazy.
Yes.
Talk to me about that real quick.
runway, the flyway.
Yeah. Literally.
Flyway.
Literally. Big up Brickerville.
Yeah, man. Big up Brickerville. Big up Anbessa. Big up Zimroy. Big up you. Big up friggin' everybody. Big up Exhale Images. The lovely photographer.
By the way, make sure you hit her.
Who's my love as well.
I'm going to tell you this. You sure have me? It's a bullshit.
because I know people. If people see my social media, you know they see that they see the Chris looking forward to them, and you know. So I just want to big up my queen with that, you know.
Man,
yeah. So
right after I said that, the viewers should have started. Uh-oh. 7, 6, 5. Like damn, I stayed on here for all this time. But I love your work. I love your work. She's doing her thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I don't know what you do. I have no skills when it comes to photography. None of that. I can't draw a straight line. None of that about it. It's not me. But I just love. I was talking to Krista the other day.
Mm.
We had some other work done by others, and I showed her the stuff, and she's like, well, damn. You know, yeah. I need to get that. So, nice. Exhale Images.
Yeah.
We're going to tag you, hashtag you and everything else. Instagram, Facebook, and the whole nine. She does her thing.
Thank you. All right.
Go on Instagram pages. Go on Paul Anthony's page. Go on Ryan@GCole, and you'll see some stuff, some tags there.
Yeah.
Nice. Thank you. Keep it up. Nice work. Also, I love it.
Just want to say big up Rodney Cooper as well, who shot Runway.
Easy. You know what I mean? Bless up Rodney.
Yeah, yeah. Mm-hmm. Got to give him respect, you know. So, yeah, man.
And the Reggae Soldiers.
Reggae Soldiers as well, you know. Yeah. Beautiful, like, amazing musicians, you know what I mean? I'm thankful to be amongst these people, man, amongst everybody here in South Florida, you know.
I
appreciate the love, and, you know, also got a new song out called Go Girl with a youth named Nico Allen. That's out there too.
I saw that.
Yeah.
And the video is out, right?
No, we don't have the video yet.
Yeah. So I saw some images.
It was like a studio, behind the scenes, between the scenes, you know.
So Nico's an R&B artist.
Huh?
Is he an
R&B? Yeah, he's an R&B artist, R&B pop from South Florida as well.
And you're bringing some dancehall flavor to it.
Yeah, man.
Mad. Is the song actually out yet?
It's out, yeah. It's called You Go Girl. It's out there everywhere.
So. All right. Drop, but we're gonna be playing that one too, because I heard it and I'm like, yo, this is kind of dope.
Respect. Big up Nico.
Come through one of these days, man. We'll talk about it. Stars in the Backyard. he's located here.
Yeah, he's in South Florida, yeah. Further south, I think. Yeah.
Nice. We'll make it happen.
Yeah, man. Respect, well, G. Thank you, man. Every time.
I appreciate you all coming through, man. Thank you so much for coming through, the legendary.
Yeah,
thank you so much, the future legendary.
Thank you.
And thank you so much for you coming through, the lady with the lens.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Big up the listeners. Big up the viewers
out there. Bless up who's on right now. One bless up EK, Denise. Thank you so much, Michael. Everybody out there. There's a whole bunch of people. Leroy, Courtney, Darcel. Everybody logged in right now.
Love. You know?
Appreciate it. Keep on doing what you're doing, man.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. I appreciate you. Come on out this Saturday. You'll see me down at VP Records. Again, I'll have on a Homegrown with G-Cole hat. Come out, holla, say hello.
Nice.
I might even have some stuff for you. All right? Yeah. Come out. But on behalf of my listeners, I thank you so much for blessing us with your time, for passing through. Much appreciated.
Yes, sir.
My love, man.
Thank you. And there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for tuning in. It has indeed been a pleasure. Be sure to subscribe to the podcast, Homegrown with G-Cole. Available on iTunes, Google Play, Stitcher, TuneIn, Spotify, iHeartRadio, all your podcast platforms. Again, subscribe to the YouTube channel, Homegrown with G-Cole. Check out the website, homegrownwithgcole.com, to listen. And for all things Homegrown, remember, be safe, be kind, be good to each other. My name is G-Cole. This is Homegrown. Let's get into this song one more time. It's called Wake Up Everybody. Keep it moving, keep it grooving. It is Homegrown.
Wake up all the teachers. Stop to teach a new way. Maybe then they'll listen to what you have to say. They're the ones who's coming up. The world is in their hands.
Courtney, big up yourself. Thank you so much for joining.
Teach them the very best you can. The world won't get no better if we just let it be. No. The world won't get no better. We gotta change it, yeah. You and me.
There you have it. Thank you so much for tuning in. It has indeed been a pleasure. Remember, be safe, be kind, and be good to each other. My name is G. Cole, and this is Homegrown.